Hello everyone. In this lesson, we will continue to learn about the Smart Dedupe feature and the Smart Compression feature. First, let's learn about Smart Dedupe. Smart Dedupe is also known as the feature of duplicate data deletion. Its abbreviation, sometimes we simply call it heavy deletion. It is a data reduction technique that eliminates redundant data blocks in our storage system, reduce the physical storage capacity occupied by this data. So this is Smart Dedupe. In our products, in Huawei's products, it supports a function like online deletion and post-processing similarity deletion. Online deduplication is the process of deduplication before writing to the disk. And then dealing with similarity deduplication, it's my data that is first written into our disk. Then, when the disk system is idle, read the data and perform operations such as duplicate data deletion. So first, let's take a look at the principle of online heavy deletion. Online compaction is the operation performed before data is written to the disk. So for the data that needs to be deleted, we divide it into blocks. Next, the storage system will use the hash algorithm to calculate the data block that I want to write in. What is its fingerprint information? So calculate the corresponding fingerprint information respectively. Then, this fingerprint information is compared with our representation. It refers to comparing the fingerprint information corresponding to this fingerprint in the fingerprint database. Check if they are consistent. If the comparison results are not the same, that indicates the data I just wrote in is a new block. It's a new block. If it's the same, then at this time my storage system will continue to compare. To proceed with a byte-by-byte comparison, then if the comparison results are the same, it indicates that it is an old block. If it's different, it means it's a new block. For instance, like this FP1, when it is compared, it is the same, right? Then compared it byte by byte and found it to be the same. Then at this time, it is an old block. So for this new block and the old block, what would you find as the result of the comparison in the end? Either it's a new block or it's an old block. If it is for an old block, it will store the fingerprint information of this data block in the fingerprint library, as well as the storage location, mapping relationship, a record pointing to the original data block. If it is a new block, it will write this new data block to our disk. Write to our hard disk and record the fingerprint information of this data block in the fingerprint library. And a timer relationship of the storage location. A timer relationship. So this is the principle of online heavy deletion. Next, let's continue to look at the principle of post-processing similarity deletion. The post-processing similarity deletion that we just discussed, it involves data first being written to our disk. At this time, your system resources are used for handling business operations, right? When the system is idle, then read these data, then proceed with the deletion. The specific process, similarly, data like this that needs to be deleted also needs to be partitioned. After the data is divided into blocks, calculate the fingerprint for each data block. How to calculate? It is through this sequential fingerprint algorithm. Calculate a fingerprint information for the newly written data block, which is the subsequent fingerprint information. Then write this data into our storage device. It is also written into our hard drive. And the fingerprint information and location information of this data block recorded in our duplicate deletion opportunity table. So this is a whole process, the storage system. It also periodically checks whether there are similar fingerprint information in our opportunity table. If it exists, then it will execute the previous operation and recalculate. If it's not the case, then continue with the periodic checks. And it passes through byte-by-byte comparison, confirm whether the data blocks with similar results are the same. If it's the same, then delete this block of data. If and in the fingerprint database, this fingerprint information of the data block, as well as the storage location, the mapping relationship, refers to the record pointing to the original data block. If we talk about similarity, just similarity. So the storage system will compress the data blocks incrementally, record this fingerprint information into this fingerprint table, and update this fingerprint information into our data elements, among the data block elements, and reclaim the space of these data blocks. So this is the principle of two post-processing similarity deletions. So let's take a look at the application scenarios of the heavy deletion feature. What about this VDI application? It is a common application scenario in the deletion of duplicate data. in this application, users generally create multiple virtual images on a single storage device. So there will be a large amount of duplicated data between the images. Duplicate data is gradually increasing. In that case, if the storage space cannot meet the requirements of business operations, at this time, we can use this delete and redelete feature, delete the repeated data between each image. In this way, we can free up our storage. Resources. After the resources are released, it can be used to store more business data. This is one of its application scenarios, redeletion application scenarios. So about the process of deleting heavy configurations, similarly, it is also necessary to first check the license's permission, check the availability of this delete function, then enable this deduplication function for LUN, enable this smart dedupe feature. So this is the entire configuration process. Next, we continue to learn about the smart compression feature. This is what we call the data compression feature. It refers to, without losing any information, by reorganizing our data, reduce the amount of data to save storage space. In this way, the transmission processing of the storage system can be improved and storage efficiency. And Huawei's Ocean Store, what about the storage system of the Dorado series selection layer? It supports online compression and post-compression. Online compression is when data is written to the disk before. We are compressing. It is the data that is first compressed and then written to the disk. If compressed later, the data is first written to the disk. Then take it out and compress it when you're free. Next, let's learn about the principle of compression. Take the string as an example. As shown in the figure, we demonstrate the compression process and the data output after compression. In that case here, firstly, there is a compressed window. We compress the window into a string, this A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Then when I'm about to compress the segment of data, firstly, ABC, right? ABC needs to be compressed. It will start searching from the first character with the compressed window, the longest identical string. After searching, we found that this ABC is the same as the previous ABC, isn't it? There is a repetition, so we will record the string, its offset in the window, and the longest match length, record the length like this, 03. So the window moves backward next. We are dealing with this string HJ to be compressed, right? To compare it with the window compressed by HJ and this window, we found no duplicates, no identical strings. So VHJ, it can be output, output HJ. The window continues to move back, then compare this string of characters, compare ABCHJ with this side. The same is from the first window. Start searching for the most similar from the first string. Go to the longest identical string. Then we can find that ABCHJ is duplicated here. So it will record the relevant guidelines here. So we can see that the longest match length is 5. Final words, if we look at what was originally a string of data, I can compress the data behind me like this, and this is just an index. It is equivalent to this record. It's a record. It is much, much, much smaller than the real data. So speaking in general, then you can compress this space, conduct a reduction. This is our compression principle. So if the compression characteristic is applied, actually, it's usually in the database. The database is one of the best application scenarios for our data compression. In a general database, do you need to store a lot of data? Then, many users are willing to accept the slight impact on business performance of the storage system, which results in a saving of over 65% in storage space. Only if the user is willing to accept this performance, exchange a slight performance impact for more storage space, what about the file service? It is also a common application scenario for our data compression. There's also engineering data, geological and seismic data, etc. These are all achievable through data compression to save storage space, such a goal. Besides this, there are also scenarios involving heavy deletion and compression. We can combine smart dedupe and smart compression, that is, the two features of deletion and compression, combined use, applied to our data development testing system, document business system, or say engineering data systems, and so on. Through such an application, we can achieve the best space saving effect. At the same time, if these two applications are combined, if used, it can also reduce to some extent, that is the procurement cost and maintenance cost. After using the heavy deletion compression feature, the amount of data written to the SSD and the number of times data is written will decrease. So this will also reduce the wear on our SSD. The lifespan of that SSD drive can also be relatively extended. So this is a coordinated scenario for heavy deletion compression. So the configuration of compression features, it also requires checking the license permission first and then enable the compression feature. So this is its configuration process. First, check availability. Then enable the compression function for LUN. Finally, let's review this lesson. In this lesson, mainly studied smart dedupe and smart computation, its working principle, application scenarios, and configuration process through heavy deletion compression technology. The two techniques of heavy deletion and compression, either used alone or in combination. What is effective is reducing redundant data, reduce the physical space occupied by the data, storage space, reduce the operating costs of our enterprise. So these are the characteristics of deleting and compressing them. So that's the content of this lesson. Thank you for studying. See you next class.